Learner, a very warm welcome to all of you in the MOOCs of Energy Resources and its Conversion Process. Today, we are going to discuss the very first module of this course, Energy and its Forms. I am your instructor for this course. I am Dr. Shweta Tripathi, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering from SOET IGNU, New Delhi. Energy, as we all are studying it from standard 5th, that the capacity to do work is known as energy. We are using energy in its various form, either in heat, electricity, it comes from sun, it comes in the form of wind, and we are going to convert it from one form to another. As we all have learned that energy is neither created nor destroyed. It is only converted into one form to another. So here we will discuss what energy is, what are its various forms, in which unit we are going to measure energy, and what are the forms in which we are going to convert it. Suppose if you are doing any work, if you are moving, you are reading, you are playing, for any of the activity, you need energy. Suppose you are reading these lines that are in front of you, you are using energy. You are watching me, you are consuming energy. You are hearing me, then also you are consuming energy. From where you get this energy? You get this energy either from your breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Any living entity, either it is plant or animal, they are relying on external source of energy. It comes in the form of radiation from the sun in case of green plants, with the help of which they prepare their food during the process of photosynthesis. For animals or for humans like us, we consume the chemical energy that is stored in the form of food. Why we are calling food a chemical energy? Is it a fuel for us? Yes, it is, because fuel is the form of energy that is burnt. The chemical energy is the energy that comes out from the fuel after burning it. And this food is burnt inside our body. So the chemical energy in some form is utilized by us and animals. You do many works. For example, you move, you read, you play, you run, even you sleep, then also you need energy. This energy comes from the food you consume. You may also conclude that the food has energy. In a similar way, you can observe several things around you which are changing and they have energy. Suppose if water is changing into ice, there is energy. Ice is melting into water, there is energy. Water is evaporating into vapor, it also takes energy. So everywhere there is energy. Fan is rotating, there is energy. Laptop is charging, there is energy. Bulb is there is energy. Everywhere you, whatever you are seeing, whatever you are watching, whatever you are doing, it has some energy. Now the thing is, where this energy comes from, because it can't be created and it is neither destroyed also. So where is it coming from? So the major thing is that energy is always conserved. It means that it can neither be created nor be destroyed. We are only transforming it from one form to another. For example, if you are seeing this electricity, where is it coming from? It is coming from some grid. From where grid is taking this electricity? From some power plant. And how the power plant is producing energy? From the steam. How steam is formed? By coal, by burning coal in the boiler, or by giving the diesel supply. So there is something. So chemical energy of the fuel is converted into electrical energy, and this electrical energy could be used in any form. Either you save it in battery and run your car, or you utilize it in watching your television, or you utilize this electricity in lighting your bulb, or you can take this fuel directly into your car and use it for the movement of your car. Which kind of energy is there in the car? Car is moving forward, so it is a kinetic energy. So there are various forms of energy that we are going to convert: electrical energy into mechanical energy, mechanical energy into heat energy, heat energy into again electricity, and all. So there, in energy, you can say that it is difficult to define energy, but it is easy to understand what energy can do. Without energy, we can't do anything. We can change form and can be used to do useful work. Now the question is, do we store energy in the form and can convert it also into the useful work? Do we convert all the energy into the useful work? Certainly no. Some of the energy is lost in between. We will see it in our next lecture. Then, all the changes in the universe involve the interaction between energy and matter. Whether it is solar energy, it is the original source of most of the Earth's available energy, and we are going to convert this energy. Matter can be converted into energy. The total amount of energy in a closed system is conserved, although it is not always available to do useful work. Sometimes we can convert it into useful work, sometimes we may not be able to convert into useful work. Some form of the energy or some percentage of the energy is only converted into useful work, which is known as the available energy as well. Energy might be the best described when we see what it can do for us. You know that we can't see energy, but we can feel its effect. We cannot make energy, but we can definitely use it. We can't destroy energy, but we can waste it, which means that we should use it efficiently. We are not using energy efficiently. Why? Because when we are converting energy from one form to another, there are many losses in the form of heat, in the form of waste particles, in the form of ash and whatever. We have to minimize the stages involved in the conversion process so that we could increase the efficiency at the end use. Energy is widely defined as the capacity. As we discussed, that capacity to do work is known as energy. Now, what is work? You can say that work is the transfer of energy from one form to another. Whether all energy is transferred to work or not, how we will decide it? It depends upon the quality or grade of the energy. The two most common forms of energy used by us are heat and electricity. Heat is generally known as the lower grade of energy, and electricity is the higher grade of energy. Why? Because the electricity, major portion of the electricity could be converted into work, but the major portion of heat is not converted into the work. This is why we call heat as low grade energy and electricity as higher grade energy. This grade of energy depends upon the quality of the energy that we are getting from it. We use energy to do work and make all the movements. When we eat, our body transforms the food energy to do work. When we run or walk or do some work, we burn energy in our bodies. Cars, planes, and machineries also transform energy into work. Work means moving or lifting something. There should be some displacement. Then we'll call it work. Force into displacement. Either we are pushing anything or we are pulling anything, and there is a displacement. That means the position of that particular thing is changed. Then only we will call it work. Otherwise, it is not work. We'll call it zero work. Suppose you are sitting and not doing any movement, it is not a work. Maybe you are in the process of thinking, but really in the terms of energy, in terms of work or in physics, will not consider it as work. Work means something should be moved, it should be displaced, or lifting something, warming, lighting, anything. Some displacement should be there. There are many sources of energy that help to run the various machines. Running water helps turbine to rotate. It rotates the turbine and the blades of turbine displaces and the work is done. Wind moves the blades of the turbines. So there is also energy. Which form of energy is there? It is a kinetic energy. Wherever there is a motion in energy, it will be kinetic energy. So the work capacity to do work is energy, and work is the displacement of any object. That means to displace any object, whatever we need is known as energy. One of the basic measuring blocks for energy is called a BTU or British Thermal Unit. It is defined as the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of 1 pound of water by 1 degree Fahrenheit at sea level. 1 BTU equals about 1 black tip kitchen mat. It takes about 2000 BTU to make a cup of coffee. Have you even imagined that while making a cup of coffee, you are spending 2000 BTU of energy? Energy can also be measured in joules. Joule is the name of scientists. 1 joule is the amount of energy needed to lift 1 pound to about 9 inch. It takes 1000 joules to equal a BTU. It would take 2 million joules to make a cup of coffee. Can you imagine? Kilojoule. Kilojoule means, kilo means 1000. So kilojoule means 1000 joules is equal to 1 kilojoule and is equivalent to 1 BTU power. It is the, what is power? It is rate of doing work. That means work done within that time is known as power. Power is equal to work upon time. What is work? Work is defined as force into displacement. So force into displacement divided by time is known as power. If we are weighing something to a height, then it is height into weight divided by time. So everywhere we are consuming energy, and the measure unit in which we are measuring this energy is kilojoule. We also measure it in the terms of kilocalorie as well. An energy source. What is the source of energy? From where we are getting this energy? An energy source is a substance or a system that is capable of delivering net kilowatt hours of energy to the system. For example, gasoline, you know very well, petrol, it is a net energy source. The various energy sources are renewable energies like biomass, biofuels, biogas, wind, hydropower, and some commercial energy sources are also available. Non-renewable or conventional energy sources like fossil fuels, coal, oil, and natural gases are also available. These are known as source because from here we fetch out the energy to convert it into the useful form. Now comes the carriers. What are the energy carriers? The carriers are the substances which helps to move energy in a usable form from one place to another. Batteries, flywheels, utility pump, storage, and terrestrial hydrogen are typical examples of energy carriers. They store the energy and give it to us when we need them. They are energy carriers, or you may call them energy transfer systems, because first you have to fill them with energy. First, you will give them energy, then they will store it and you can utilize it whenever you need. So, you have to first fill them with energy before you can utilize them or empty them. Now comes the sink. What is sink? We have learned source. Source is from where we are fetching energy. Now, the energy that we have fetched, we have stored it into the carriers. Now, something should be there which consume this energy that is fetched out from the source and is contained into the carrier. So, this is known as sink. Sink is any means that consumes more energy than it returns as a new energy. For example, solar photovoltaic or PV system. It may be a net energy sink. Why? Somebody would say, but we are using PV to generate electricity, then why it is a sink? It is sink because it is taking energy from the sun. This energy from the sun comes to the PV and PV only contains the energy that it could take it from the source, that is sun, and it gives or consumes more energy rather than it deliver as a new. So the energy that it is taking from the sun is more, and the energy that it is transforming to the form of electricity or in the form of heat is less. So solar photovoltaic system is a net energy sink because in totality consumes more energy, more old energy than it has yet to deliver as new. If your solar panel is generating rupees 10 worth of electricity a day and the interest cost is rupees 12 per day, you have a net energy sink. It means if it is giving us some profit, then it is sold. If it is not giving us the profit, it is a sink. It is absorbing the energy. Now, the electricity or electric energy is capable of almost complete conversion into work. If we talk about the grades of energy, then only we can identify source and sink, because source will be always the higher grade of energy. So the electrical energy, we have talked that it is high quality energy or high grade energy because it is capable of almost complete conversion into work, while thermal energy or heat is capable only of partial conversion into work. We can say that electricity is of high quality or high grade of energy, and the same quantity of energy after use has less capacity for work. So we can say that it is the ability of energy to do work which sets its quality. Some examples of quality of energy is, suppose 1 kg of electrical energy has more capacity for doing work than 1 kg of heat energy. 1 kg of wood energy has more capacity for doing work than 1 kg of ocean energy or the energy in the form of seawater. So, it is a comparatively high grade or low grade. In some cases it will be a low grade energy, and in some cases it will be a high grade energy. It depends upon the quality of energy, how much it is going to convert. When energy is concentrated in a small space, we call it a high grade energy, like electricity and chemical energy. The high grade energy should be used for high grade applications rather than low grade application. Like heating of water, it is a low grade application, and generation of electricity is a high grade. So the particles of molecules that store these forms of energy are highly ordered and compact. When we go for the low grade energy, that is in the form of thermal energy or heat energy, the incomplete transfer into work will be there. In the case of high grade energy, the complete transfer of work will take place, while in case of thermal energy, incomplete transfer of work will take place. Low grade energy is characterized where the particles or molecules that store this form of energy are randomly distributed. For example, heat is a low grade energy. This low grade energy, that is heat, how we will characterize it? It will be characterized on the basis of temperature and pressure. Temperature and pressure are related to energy contained in a substance. Heat is a form of energy and temperature and is a measure of its thermal effects. We measure temperature in degree Celsius, Fahrenheit and Kelvin Celsius. We may recall that the steam engines that are used in railways, where the heat energy was used to rotate the flywheel of these engines. We make use of heat energy daily in diverse areas. We get our homes electricity which comes from the thermal power stations. Pressure is an indicator of stored energy. The steam at high pressure contains more energy than that at low pressure. So the storage of energy depends upon the temperature and pressure. Depending upon this temperature and pressure only, we will say that whether what is the quality of that energy, whether it is high grade energy or low grade energy. You may know that heat is a form of energy. It is the energy of moving particles, atoms and molecules of liquids, gas and solid matter. As I had already told that calorie is its unit, but nowadays joule is used as a SI unit. What is specific heat? Specific heat is the quantity of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 kg of substance through 1 degree centigrade. That means if the quantity of heat is Q and is supplied to a substance having mass m and the specific heat Cp, then will be given as Q is equal to mCp delta T, where delta T is the increase in temperature. If you want to do a practical, just do in your home. If you are going to give same amount of heat to water and milk, which will gain more temperature, then it will tell you which has more specific heat. Suppose if you are burning an iron rod and if you are burning a steel, whether their temperature will rise at similar time if you are giving them same amount of heat? No, it will depend upon their specific heat. Now comes the internal energy. As name itself says, it is related to the internal structure of the substance. It means the translations, rotational and vibrational energies of the molecules are the example of internal energy. All these energies could be influenced by the interaction of heat. Internal energy depends upon the temperature of the substance. Now, what are the various forms of energy? Energy. If it is stored, it is in the form of potential energy. If it is working, it is in the form of kinetic energy. This potential energy could be of different nature. It could be stored, energy stored. That means if it is stored inside a fuel, it is in the form of chemical energy. If it is stored in the atoms and molecules, it is in the form of nuclear energy. If it is stored in a substance which is at height, it will be the gravitational energy. Then comes the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy means you are in motion. Something is in motion. So radiant energy, that is coming from the sun, is also kinetic energy. Thermal energy. Thermal energy in the form of heat, but it is working. So it is a form of kinetic energy. Then motion. Motion means we are moving. If anything is moving, it will have kinetic energy. Potential energy is the stored energy and the energy of position, that is gravitational. It exists in many forms as told. Chemical energy. In chemical energy, the energy stored in the bonds of atoms and molecules is called chemical energy. Examples of stored chemical energy are petrol, diesel, kerosene, natural gas, coal, dew burn, it is also chemical energy, wood dew burn, it is chemical energy, cow dungs, manures, cow dungs, other biomass, etc. You burn, anything you burn, it is fuel and the energy stored in it is chemical energy. It is released as heat when these fuels are burnt. Now comes the nuclear energy. As I told that if the energy is stored in the nucleus of an atom, the energy that holds the nucleus together, it is called nuclear energy. The examples are nucleus of uranium atom. Modern societies are using nuclear energy in nuclear power station to generate electricity, to power submarines and ships, etc. Then stored mechanical energy. The energy stored in the objects by the application of force is called stored mechanical energy. And the examples of this type of mechanical energy are compressed rings, stretched rubber, springs, flywheels, etc. Then comes the gravitational energy. It is the energy by virtue of place or position. It is called gravitational energy. The water stored in reservoir in a dam is the best example of gravitational energy. If you are going to rotate the turbine, what happens? This stored water, when comes in the speed, it rotates the turbine. With that speed that we get the rotation of that level, that we are able to generate electricity. This energy can be released when the flow of the water is controlled to produce electricity at a dam. Now comes the energy of motion, that is kinetic energy. Like the motion of waves, electrons, atoms, etc. It is called kinetic energy. The kinetic energy also exists in many forms, the most important being the radiant energy. This radiant energy is electromagnetic energy. We are familiar with X-rays, visible light, radio waves, gamma rays, etc. All these are radiant energy. The energy that is coming from the sun, solar energy, is also a radiant energy. The internal energy of substance is called thermal energy. Geothermal energy is an example of thermal energy. Then comes the motion. Motion means the movement of any substance from one place to another, and the energy is associated with this. These examples of this are wind energy and hydropower electricity. Then comes the sound. The movement of energy through substance in longitudinal waves is called sound waves. We measure it in terms of the frequency. Then comes the electrical energy. It is the movement of electrons, so it is also electrical energy. So the example includes electricity and lighting as well. Now as we see that energy is all around us. Energy exists in many forms. Energy can be detected by our senses. Energy is stored in different situations. Energy can change form and can be used to do useful work. All changes in the universe involves the interaction between energy and matter. Now if we see the example near our own home, inside our own home, then we could see that if we are going to burn something, there is chemical energy. If we are moving forward, there is kinetic energy. If something is at height, it is potential energy. Now may I ask you that which kind of energy is there when a car moves? The car moves in a translatory motion, so there is a movement. So this type of energy is kinetic energy. What happens when an airplane moves? When an airplane moves, it moves in the forward direction also, but it attains a height also. So what kind of energy will be there? Suppose if you are moving only, there is motion only, it is kinetic energy. If you are at height or something is at height, there is some vertical distance, then it is potential energy. So when we are talking about the airplane, which kind of energy will be there? There will be both potential energy and kinetic energy as well. Because when airplane is at height, it is storing energy in the form of potential energy. And when it is moving forward, it is in the form of kinetic energy. So it is not that only one form of energy is changing into another. There may be two, three or more than that forms which are going to convert. This is all about energy and its forms. In our next lecture, we will discuss thermodynamics and electrical energy, how we are generating, what is active power, what is reactive power, and all. Thank you very much.